And welcome back. Now, we're looking for satellites or something. So, I always forget.
Anomaly detected.
Good. Where? This is the only thing that's not, like, glowing is this asteroid. Don't remember if you've been here or not. Might as well give it a try. I like these little solar system quests. It's pretty cool. Have I seen this before? Still says progression 100%. This asteroid contains large quantities of frozen water, unusual for this particular asteroid belt, and a possible host for microbial life. Yes, I guess we've seen this and mined it or whatever for it before.
Anomaly on sensors.
Oh, that's right. That's how we do it.
Probes launched. Getting a scan.
Cool. And Garen's satellite nav point. Let's go check it out. Watch out for that scourge there. Getting close.
According to that astronomer on Aya, a satellite should be here.
I'm not detecting anything. If it was here, it's gone.
You mean destroyed?
I mean gone. Destruction would leave debris. We've got nothing.
Debris.
Let's try another nav point.
Right, so satellite ID, power reading system report status, everything not available. This is the nav point provided by Mariko Derej, but there is neither evidence of a satellite nor debris from one. Although we gain research data. Alright. These things are so cool looking when you move around like that. It's almost like it is like a huge frickin' like microscopic microbial life, right? Like a virus just taking over. Well, we're not scanning anything this time. Am I supposed to find it on my own? Oh, Gavorkum is over there. Oh, it's a new system. Cool. We still have these two. These two, actually. Farrowing, which has Havarl in it, and Gerator. So yeah, we'll go here first. That makes sense. Get your Doctor Who music ready. Just don't run into that black hole. That would be bad.
System, Gavorkum. Approaching Kadara.
Besides being a haven for Nexus exiles, what do we know about this place?
Group of exiles called the Outcast liberated Kadara Port from the Ket. Until recently, their power was absolute. But a new gang, the Collective, has been chipping it away. Real shady bastards led by an unknown called the Charlatan.
Well, with luck, they'll be too busy shooting at each other to notice us.
The charlatan, huh? Alright, let's check out the outermost planet. We're going to look at all the planets like we always do. Thivernos. It belongs to thee. Yeah, I like these little sequences. Pretty cool.
Anomaly detected.
Ah. Okay. No atmospheres, look at that. It is freaking cold. -210°C. A massive ball of rock and frozen methane. Thivernos has little apparent material or scientific value. Would-be miners from Kadara keep scanning it, just in case. Let's see what we got here. Probe away. Oop.
Deploying probe. Tracking a huge mineral deposit.
Yeah, it's beryllium. A metal ideal for lightweight construction and a variety of applications. This deposit is readily accessible. So we will access it. Got 131 of that. That's that.
Anomaly on sensors.
Uh-huh. Check out the anomaly then.
Probes launched. Getting a scan.
Starship wreckage. I'm gonna head there second last. Let's go to Trobroar. I'd like to, you know, build suspense and stuff. Trobroar. Loosely translated, Trobroar is the Krogan word for cinder or ash heap. This massive desert world harbors no life, water, or materials, or minerals actually, of any use. How sad. Mine? Does that mean there is a mine, or the planet is named Mine? So we'll find out. About 10 seconds.
Anomaly on sensors.
I saw that description flash, too. Yeah, it's called Mine. Cobalt and boron are among the resources available on the aptly, if unimaginatively, named Mine. Workers struggle under heavy gravity and frigid temperatures to bring their prizes home. I guess we're gonna find stuff to mine.
Probe away. Getting a scan.
I love her accent. So we found a mountain. Its origin is tectonic. Height is 9.4 kilometers. Dense and radioactive metals make portions of mine difficult to scan. This mountain, thick with valuable minerals, has gone undiscovered until our arrival. Well, to the victor goes the spoils. We just got 270 experience points. Okay. Okie dokie. Anything else? Alright, we'll check out Backer and then we'll go to the starship wreckage. Disputes among exiles break out frequently over Backer. The gas giant is useful for ships looking to replenish their helium-3 supplies, and thus a resource to be claimed. And there's a moon right there. Boop. Okay. So now this wreckage. Delay there, huh? Ship identity unknown. Ship name unknown. Crew complement unknown, but estimate 5 to 8. Status not available. The paltry remains of a Ket dropship. Whoever destroyed it thoroughly scavenged its parts, but perhaps there's something they missed. Perhaps. I actually found a bunch of goodies. Scrap stuff that we can sell. Alright. Yeah, it's really picked apart there. Exploded, etc. I call it an episode now, but it's too... It's not enough time. It's only 20 minutes. So we'll continue on to our destination. There's not a lot of, what do you call it here? I can see a little bit of, what do you call it? Stuff. The Scourge.
Standing order for all incoming ships. The port is a ceasefire zone by order of Sloan Kelly. She was head of Nexus Security.
Huh. Be ready for anything. And keep comms open. Should hear from our resistance contact soon.
Kadara. A mountainous world originally settled by the Angara, Kadara is now a haven for Nexus, exiles, and pirates. In addition to this criminal element, the planet is plagued by toxic water caused by an atypical amount of sulfide minerals. Assuming danger there. Well, I guess we're landing. So we're gonna wait for something, but... Let's just go. Yeah, I can see some scars there. The black hole keeps creeping me out, too.
Incoming call. Patching it through.
There's been a development regarding the spy, Venturev. Rendezvous at Crawler's Song. Your contact's code name is Shena.
Shena. Got it.
Barely enough room to land this thing. But we did it.
That's one hell of a welcome, Stein.
Oh my.
Exiles have stepped up their game since the revolt.
Oh! I remember seeing this. This
not
exact scene.
For folk who got kicked off the station with nothing to show for it.
In the trailer. We should be allies.
Maybe we can get them back on our side.
We know they can fight Ket.
Our supplier's waiting. Come on, we're gonna be late.
Do I even want to know?
Nope.
Nope. Look for an email from Knight. Okay. Speak to the resistance contact at Krella's Song. I'm not going to be checking emails now. Can't scan anything. I don't have my gun or scanner available.
We'll find a way. We always do.
No more talking. I'm sick of your shit.
You won't get away with this. My people won't allow it.
Not for us. The Angara would have been slaughtered by the cat.
Is that them talking?
Ungrateful prick.
Nice. Wait. Oh, I can scan things. It wasn't coming out before, but now we can.
You can't do this!
This is our home.
Should have paid your protection fees then.
Oh, we can scan.
Sloan wonders why people join the collective.
Say that again. I dare you.
Well, I guess we'll go... Yeah, I can't see anything to scan. Maybe it's inside. Let's go through here if we can. Oh, that takes a long time to open. Docks. This we can't go through. This ship looks familiar. What's up? You're kind of scraggly looking. Cool hair though. Okay, well, nothing in here to do or talk to. Nobody to talk to. Back out to the market. It takes a long time to open for some reason.
How are we supposed to survive out there?
Not my problem. You're no better than the Nexus.
Don't blame us because you couldn't pay your fees.
Sloan's not running a fucking charity.
Wants me to scan. Hold on a second. Maybe that? Yeah, that's what you were saying. Adapted apparatus, unique operation, updating its initiative operational standards. That's the action. Recovery aside, this device is valuable for its non-standard adaptation of initiative technologies for Helios-specific operation. Field improvised devices leapfrog development cycles and provide significant research potential. Fascinating. As always, I like to head do everything last. This goes to market as well? Well, this is back to the docks, just another... What was a data pad here?
Remember, let me do the talking and we'll get out of here in one piece.
ID number, manifest tracking number, consignee Big Taran, vessel name the Svalin, point of loading Eladin, point of undocking or unloading Kadara, contains 500 pounds of scrap metal, 200 pounds of ammunition, 50 pounds of grenades, and 10 pounds of Kerrikan shells. Spare knife. Oh, Liam's here. Liam?
Everything all right?
But no one leaves the port until
they're greasing some palms so we can park the Nomad.
Want me to get involved?
Need any help?
Thanks, but I've got this. You just focus on the spy.
You know it. More core tech.
I got up close. It looks really nice. What us? That Nomad thing.
You like it, huh? There's no stealing, that's mine. Alright, so it's more docks. Oh, what does this do? Wait. I hate doing this because it takes so long to open. It looked kind of like some kind of fast travel thing over here. Oh, there's a research center as well. Transit console? Oh yeah, to return to the Tempest. Okay. Good to know. You left everything on board, right? Still asking about that knife. Alright. Outcast guard. Oh my god, what are you doing to that poor guy? What's going on here?
What are you doing to these people?
Nothing they weren't expecting. The port's got two rules. No guns and pay your protection fees.
Protection fees?
What are you, the mob?
Other way around. Outcasts of the law in Kadara. You got a problem with that? You can join these assholes.
Pathfinder, it will be difficult to find the spy if you're barred from the city.
Guess that's true.
What was that?
Nothing. I'll be on my way.
Creep.
What a sweetie. Well, that's our destination, so naturally I'm going to go there last, just so I can explore everything. Which I believe going through there heads to the other thing I saw in one of the trailers. Which I'm not going to give away. There's a data pad here. Gotta give Sloan her cut. Personal log from Yun Seo No, however you say it. Detailed drawing of a manta. New entry. For the first time in, I guess, 600 years, I feel like I can breathe. Sure, the air smells like shit, but I've got a roof over my head and food in my gut. No more running. No more Armageddon planet after Armageddon planet. I can finally just explore. That was the whole point, right? I'm going to start with figuring out the migration patterns of those manta creatures. Maybe Ligier knows. This is her home planet after all. And log. We got a mods merchant.
What you got? Nice gear. Could find something better. Check the console.
Is this stuff stolen?
Where'd you find your stock?
That information's out of your price range, friend.
Let's sell our salvage then. Ultra-rare assault rifle. The massive Ket Soned translated as resistance, rapidly unleashes plasma-surrounded projectiles after a brief charging period. Much of the sonad size is devoted to insulating the user from its own power. A damaged sonad could incinerate its wielder's hands while continuing to fire. No, we don't want to damage that. See, I think I have that. I know I have this Zalkin. I have a Carphalon something. He does sell a lot of mods, but he also sells other things. Oh, these are my items. I'm like, I have that. Well, let me just look. So I do have this. Okay, so Coma RPG, an explosive projectile launched from an Omni tool that deals massive damage. Really? I guess that's like a consumable. Yeah, it's a consumable. Pretty cool. We can use it against that architect thing. Thoken 4. The Ket Thoken, translated to sudden death, fires tracking enabled plasma surrounded rounds. The tracking effect, enabled by magnetic field adjusters in the projectiles, is slight but useful, particularly given the Thoken's low ammunition capacity. With such a weapon, accuracy is everything. Look how much room we have for damage. Like, could we find stuff that's like filled with damage? It's like barely making a dent in the clip size and damage. And this Zalkin I was wondering about. The Ket Zalkin rifle is a mainstay among Ket forces. The semi-automatic weapon can be overcharged to release its standard plasma-surrounded projectiles in a 3-round burst at increased power, a feature which earned the weapon its name, roughly translated as 3 stars. This is a Carphalon. The Ket Carphalon blade can directly inject the user's hand with a variety of neurochemical stimulants. The Carphalon reinforces the body's reward mechanisms, allowing a combatant to overcome pain and fatigue after successful strikes. The weapon's ability to adapt to various species suggests the Ket occasionally give them to favored vassals. Okay, so what does he have? It looks like he really... Wait. He really does just sell mods. I'm not gonna look at them, but I'm... I kind of get the feeling that if he sells so many mods, and he specializes in mods... ...that you could find some really uncommon ones here. That possibly you couldn't find anywhere else. At least at this point. Getting worse, huh? At least in their eyes. Some of the red things catch my eye, but they're already red.
Nice.
Thanks. What are you doing? Personal log, Addo. New entry. Saw an Asari placing cameras around the port. Little things, hard to find, hard to see. Must be a collective operative, the charlatan's eyes and ears. Asked Shelley if I should tell Sloane's guards. She said it would only bring trouble. Probably right. Don't want to get caught up in the crossfire. Better to keep a low profile. End log. So I see plants, and I think, well, we could scan these, but no. No results. Let's check up here. I'll just thoroughly explore this place. Dead endo. Good place to get mugged. Walking into me. Armor merchant.
A squishy thing like you needs protection. Got the best armor in all of Kadara.
Steep prices. I haven't looked at the prices yet.
Bold claim. Let's see what you've got.
Everything's on the console.
Which is just as Maverick armor. This patchwork hard suit mixes various materials and technology from the Helios cluster, and its microframe computer runs a jumble of barely linked programs. Despite this, or because of it, the armor is highly effective in combat, with targeting and thermal distribution systems second to none. Upgrades smooth out the armor's technological integration seams and provide added comfort. Do I have something like that? I've seen this Maverick armor before. Oh, I did look at it and didn't pick it up. Headshot. Spare ammo. Really good for that, huh? But does it actually give you a higher AC, or does it just give you these things? Alright, gonna pass then.